when anti-cop vitriol swept the country last summer, the Trump White House stood by our men and women in uniform. But as police once again come under attack, Team Biden seems intent on doing everything they can to demoralize and demonize law enforcement. Joining me now, Mark Meadows, former Trump White House chief of staff. Mark, what's going on here? Biden used to be Mr. Law and Order, and now he's just like any garden variety, you know, woke activist on the street.
Well, Laura, it took Joe Biden 90 days, almost 3 months last summer, to condemn the violence in Minneapolis and Wisconsin. And what we're seeing is it's taken him 100 days to show his true colors, that he's against law enforcement. He's not willing to stand up for the men and women in blue. He's all about lurching to the left. Moderate Joe Biden is gone, lurching to the left to make sure that what happens is that he puts forth an agenda that supports the Congresswoman Tlaib, the Maxine Waters, Congresswoman Maxine Waters, and their radical leftist agenda.
Well, speaking of, she doesn't think her inciting of violence ahead of the Chauvin trial, Mark, is going to matter at all if the case is appealed. Watch.
The judge was all off track, and he knows that this is not the cause of an appeal. Most of the time, and you have a case like this, they're going to appeal it anyway. But to say that I'm going to cause an appeal really is not credible.
Mark, if you were still in Congress, you would have gotten away with that kind of response, right, if you had said something similar?
Well, no rational person would get away with it. And I can tell you, with her comments about being more confrontational when she goes to rioters and say, be more confrontational. But it actually aligns with Kamala Harris, who says, you know, she was encouraging them to not let up over the summer and to stay there and bail out some of these protesters. Let me tell you, The left is real focused on making sure that everybody keeps their COVID mask on, regardless of their age, regardless of if they've had a vaccine. But they've taken the mask off. They are not with law enforcement. And we cannot stand by. The American people need to judge for themselves, but we cannot stand by and let this continue. What we need to make sure of is in any bill that comes forward that the Democrats don't side with trial attorneys at the expense of law enforcement.
Yeah, I'm not sure why we should work with them at all on this. Well, I don't know why we're falling all over ourselves to work with people who think we have a horrible, awful, racist country. President Trump
brought in community leaders, law enforcement together last summer. It was a beautiful thing. I was there in the room when he brought these folks together and say, we can actually get police reform done. But what happened is the Democrats started making it a lot more not only politically important to their side, they started siding with the leftist activists. Here's the interesting thing. I was with a law enforcement officer earlier today, 29 years of experience. His dad had 31, 60 years of experience, and they're going to end up retiring because of this nonsense that's going on in America.
It's back to 1970s style urban America. It's going to be urban warfare. And people, you voted for this, you're getting it. So it's time to turn it around. Mark, thank you.